मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? क्लास 9 बायोलॉजी. गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? सो टू फाइट अगेंस्ट कोरोना द मोस्ट इफेक्टिव मेडिसिन इज स्टे होम, स्टे सेफ, एज वेल एज यूटिलाइज योर मैक्सिमम टाइम इन योर स्टडी. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज द सेल. गलत है, हटाओ. क्लास 9 बायोलॉजी. गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप फाइन. सो द मोस्ट इफेक्टिव मेडिसिन टू फाइट अगेंस्ट कोरोना इज स्टे होम, स्टे सेफ. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर सेल of the first unit, basic biology. In the previous chapter, we have studied about the different branches of science, that are the biology, physics, chemistry. Here today we will study about the biology, that is the study of life. So biology is the study of life or living organism, from the microscopic bacteria to use blue whale. All living organisms have a basic features in common, that is made up of building blocks called cell. These cells are in the form of independent existence and are capable of performing essential function. Every structure in the body consists of cell, whether it is animal or plant. Also, most organisms start their life as a single cell called zygote. So what is cell? It is the structural and functional unit of life. Cells are the microscopic structure cannot seen by the naked eyes, but with the advancement of magnifying aids, it is possible. Now we have much advanced techniques to reveal the tiniest structure that are present even inside the nucleus. Now, so we'll study about the invention of the microscope and the discovery of cell. We have lot of techniques, lot of devices today, but we must study about the first microscope and the discovery of cell. It was Antoni von Leeuwenhoek, a Dutch scientist, constructed first microscope. Antoni was an ordinary public official who ground lenses and made microscopic observations. Beside all, his microscopes were called simple microscope, that consist of single biconvex lens. Then Robert Hooke, an English scientist, develops compound microscope with greater magnification. Dear students, compound microscope consists of two different lenses that increases the magnification to see even the tiniest structure. In our school, we have lots of compound microscopes. Now, Robert Hooke discovered and coined the term cell by the observation of thin slice of cork under the microscope. He observed box-like compartment piled up together that remind him about the rooms or the cells of monks in his monastery, because while studying he lived in a monastery. Along with him, various monks are there, and the rooms where they used to live are called cell. On that basis, he coined the term cells are the simples, small compartments. Now come to the cell theory. Cell theory was proposed by two different scientists independently in the year 1838 and 39. Amsterdam, a German botanist, proposed that all plant life consists of cells that perform all the life processes. Theodor Kwan, a German zoologist, proposed that all plants and animals consist of cells, which are the structural and functional unit of life. Cell theory was extended by Robert Virchow in 1858, who proposed that all the cells are arise from pre-existing cells. This was the most accepted theory. Why? Whatever the life we used to see in this universe, there must be some pre-existing cells. For example, in a barren land, if a plant grows, for that plant life, there must be a seed. Now, how small the cells? So cells are microscopic with some exception, but still there are some variation on this. Smallest cells are bacterial cells, longest cell nerve cell in our body, and the largest cell that are not microscopic used in size, and the most common example is ostrich eggs. Now, how many cells in the body? If I ask one question, there are two animals. One is mouse and the other is elephant, in which the number of cells will be more. Obviously, elephant larger in size, much cells in his body. It is correct. So, cells number depend on the size of animals. The bigger an organism, greater is the number of cells in its body. Single celled, for example, amoeba, pure-celled, spirogyra, and multi-celled, human. So, dear students, learn all the things, because somehow these are important in the exam. So, goodbye. Take care yourself and stay home.